This moment, it is quite a moment. And so I reflect and I write and I'm emotionally just compelled to say some things. And so in this moment, I stand proud. I am elated. And yet I reflect. 1619, Angela. 2020, Kamala. In this moment, for four little brown girls bombed in a church basement, for little Ruby escorted, for mothers whose children were stolen, for dreams deferred and countless stories untold, for the help, for the helpless and the hopeful, the overcomers and the despite the odds achievers, for the ancestors, oh, especially for the ancestors, for no reading and no schools, to the Divine Nine and HBCUs. In this moment, I have to say something. I have something to say. This is not just for us. It's for all of them. Phyllis Wheatley, Zora, Josephine, Billy, Brianna, and Sandra, Avery Neal and Mabel Jones, Big Ma and Auntie, Madea, Granny, Mama, Harriet, Sojourner and Ida B. Wells, Shirley Chisholm, Ella Baker, Mary McLeod Bethune, Fannie Lou, Maxine Waters, Barbara Jordan. Yes, my sisters, come through. Come through. In this moment, adjust your crown and stand tall, recognizing and acknowledging God's had us through it all. Through it all, through enslavement, degradation, misogyny, glass ceilings, tribulations, and struggles. A double negative is what they tried to say. Nonetheless, baby, we always, always made a way. We are overcoming in this moment. It's true. 1920, the vote. 2020, the ability to vote for you and you and you and for my brothers too. In this moment, I am freer. I am whatever her. I am whoever her. I am woman. I am black. I am, we are not turning back.